In order to enable patients to make choices, you need to have choices available to them. But we've also created a culture in which they're continuously discussed as therapeutic options, but we go into great detail about the risks and benefits so that the patient ultimately says, well, having considered the entire which guide of treatment, I have chosen this one over that one, and these are the reasons why. So if you leave the decision to the doctor alone, then the patient has less autonomy, feels less able to make a decision, and even has less confidence to put their hand up at a critical moment and say, doctor, is this really necessary? Or is there an alternative? Now, a shared decision-making process would ensure that the patient fully understood all the issues, fully understood their options, and more importantly, the doctor fully understood what motivated the patient in the first place. And then they can begin to work together to a solution which might not involve an operation, it might merely involve dealing with a misconception in them, or indeed even in their wife or their daughter, who is in fact now stopping them doing what they want to do.
One of the options was to have an angiogram, which involves making a cut in your leg and passing an instrument through your arteries to check your arteries. Another treatment also which goes with an angiogram is an angioplasty, where they actually expand the arteries. They are invasive procedures, and my theory in my own working life is you always try the simple aspects first.
The reason why I hadn't had a bypass wasn't that it was that it's the end of the road and they can't do any more, is that that wasn't the best option available. That was probably the most traumatic one. You know what I mean? That they could offer you, and there are other options. And they've explained that in much, much detail over the years now, that I'm quite convinced the right decision was made.